Find an expression for the general term of a power series and write the series in summation notation. So here's what we're given right here. And our goal is to write this as a series, general terms in there, and then write it as a summation. And we don't know where it's going to start. It's going to start at some convenient spot, but we'll see what it is. So we see a factorial mechanism in the numerator and the denominator of the CN coefficients. See, we see this here, and this is kind of a factorial, p minus 1, p minus 2, and it stops right there. It would have gone on p minus 3, p minus 4. Now we see the coefficient, the powers on the x are pretty easy. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so let's just look at this part here first. P times P minus 1 times P minus 2 over 3 factorial. So that's this one. What's going on there? Well, the factorial stops. So I have to express that somehow. So this is P factorial all the way down to 1 divided by all the stuff we don't want. We want it to stop at P minus 2. So we'll put it in there. So here's how that works. P factorial is over here. P minus 1, P minus 2, P minus 3, P minus 4, all the way where that ends up being 1. So if we just want this, then we want to divide by P minus 3 factorial. See? So it all cancels out and just leaves us with what we wanted. Okay, so that's how that comes to be. And then we have a 3 factorial down there, so we put that here. So those are the coefficients. So the general, and that goes with the 3, goes with the 3. And the p minus 3 goes with the 3. So that's the n. So this all converts over in general to this. So, let's check the terms. If n equals 1, then here's what we're saying it is. Plug in the 1, 1 factorial, plug in the 1 up there. You get p times p minus 1 factorial. See, p factorial is p times p minus 1 times p minus 2 all the way down to 1. So I could separate it out. So I separated this out to have p and then the rest of it. And of course that's down here, cancels out. And 1 is 1, so it's just going to be px. And that is this term right here. Check. Then we go on to n equals 2. Put in n equals 2, so you have in your formula, we had this right here, this. So it's p minus 2, 2 factorial, 2, using the same kind of mechanism, burn off a couple of terms first in your p factorial, ended at p minus 2 factorial all the way down to 1. That's what this is. These cancel out. And you get this, which checks out. And then you can see, putting this, it'll check out also. Okay, so writing as a summation notation, the n did start at 1. That was the first term, so we better do 1 to infinity of this. Okay, this series is rewritten like this. Okay, here's another example. Let's say you have this one right here. It's a little bit more difficult because the exponents are jumping, but they're jumping with an odd. So that's like a 2n minus 1, a 2n plus 1 type of thing. And it's toggling plus minus plus minus. So it's got a negative one type toggle, one of these, this, or that, that kind of a thing. So the general term, what we do is use this trick. Put counter and values above the terms in such a way that the constants are easy and the x minus 1 term power is easy. So I did it this way. I could have had 0, 1, 2. I could have 3, 4, 5. I chose 1, 2, 3, 4. So I want the first one for n equal 1 to be a positive. So I better have 1 minus 1, 0. So it's positive. Then down here, look at these terms. For n equals 3, that's a 2n minus 2. That's 4 factorial, 2n minus 2. 2 times 3 is 6, minus 2 is 4. You just have to try these things. You know it's skipping by powers of 2. Well, not powers, but a factor of 2. 2, 4, 6. So it's a 2n mechanism. And just a question of how are you going to adjust it? This is a minus 2 adjustment. Okay, and then the exponents, 2n plus 1, 2n plus 1, 2n plus 1, 2n plus 1, right there. Okay, so that's a general term. And then the series rewritten into summation notation is this. And then you put a check on it. Let's say for n equals 3, negative 1 to the 3 minus 1 over 2 times 3 minus 2 factorial. That is your x minus 1. 2, 3 plus 1. So that's negative 1 squared over 4 factorial. That's 6 minus 2 factorial. 4 factorial. 6 plus 1 is 7. 1, negative 1 squared is positive. 1 over 4 factorial. X minus 1 is a 7th. And is that the term when n equals 3? Yes. There it is. Check. So if you're going to go on to differential equations, you have to get really good at this kind of thing.